Some performance debugging today. I think it's a good thing to, for you guys to have an idea how to do some performance debugging in Pixotope, or obviously in real-time engines in general. There's a big focus on performance, and within Pixotope we have a couple of tools that we have made custom for, you know, easier debugging and general just kind of overlook of how your scene is looking. I just wanted to bring you your attention to the optimization panel that we have in Pixotope. And I'll just start from the top and work my way down. So the first tab or the first button is called Fix Settings. This isn't really a debugging. This is more while you're working and while you're working with the editor. Because whenever you have another window open or another program, software, whatever, running in front of Unreal, it will slow down your scene. So you can see all the leaves, everything is paused. And once I enter Unreal, it'll start doing that animation again. And this goes for all animations. When you trigger an animation, once you have another window open, which you typically might have your director open, it's going to slow down everything going on in the background. But with the fixed settings, it adjusts your scene so that it doesn't pause any animation, it doesn't slow down any sequences or anything while you're doing anything else in front. And it's really handy when you're trying to do either some control panel testing, or, you know, if you want to have any visual feedback while you're doing some compositing, you won't have to worry about it having to pause or anything. And the rest of these settings right here are Pixotope customized statistics of how to read your scene. So the hide stats basically just removes whatever stats you have. We'll jump down to these engine stats. So if we hit the FPS, we obviously get the frames per second. And you can see that changing once we're looking around the scene. It'll drop when we have a lot of things happening, like for a river with a lot of reflections, that kind of stuff. You know, it draws a lot of performance. We also have our raw, which adds a bit more information in the right side of your screen. And these are all, depending on what you're looking for, you can get some detailed information about this. I'm not going to go too much into detail. You'll notice once you start using it that it's really helpful trying to read what's going on in your scene. If you put it the detailed, you'll get all your, basically all your engine stats running at the same time. And also down the corner, you can see whenever on this graph, you can see a bit more closely if it has any spikes in any particular areas or any particular moments. You know, you can pretty easy to spot them there, especially if you have like interval or spikes in intervals. And in a set amount of time, it's usually something going on. It's either some garbage collection or, you know, something that happens continuously. So it's easier to see how your scene is rendering. In the Unvest setting, there's, you know, it all depends. This isn't necessarily something you're going to be looking a whole lot on. There's a lot of text going on. There's a lot of information. But I just wanted you to know that you can get a lot of stuff out of these settings over here, which will make it easier for you to spot where your issues are if you're having performance drops during your rendering. So we have everything from dating objects. You know, we can see everything going on. And to remove those, you hide the stat. And I think we also had a quick look at our preview windows here. It's basically just looking at your in and output into Pixotope. So we have a raw image coming in. This is from our green screen studio. And we can also look at our masks. And if I turn off the RGB and add just alpha, we can see our actual internal key. So there's a couple of handy, you know, we should always keep an eye on these. If you're having trouble with getting any input or anything, just make sure you're having the actual input coming in, and also checking out the mask if you're having key issues when setting up the key as well. It's always really handy to be able to view it live while you're trying to adjust your key. We don't have an input media now, but if you had a separate video feed, we would have those here. But you could be viewing, you know, a live background, for instance. It's just one of the ways we can be using those. And our output video is also our fill and our key, which are separate. So you can quickly access those if you want to see what you're actually outputting from Pixotope. Now, when it comes to performance, there's, you know, there's a lot of things that can cause issues. And it's basically just sort of tracking down where your problems are. But the most, I think the most common things that are pulling, you know, that are very performance heavy, is typically things like reflections. If you're having some complex reflections like we are, these are pretty detailed. That's something that would usually take a lot of performance. We have a lot of complex shaders in this scene as well. I can show you how to act or how to get a view to have a look at how what's actually going on in your scene when looking at the shaders, because it's always kind of hard to know, you know, what's drawing a lot of performance and what's light working with. So up in the upper left corner of our viewport, we have a lot of different options of how to view our scene. And if we go to the lit panel, down here in optimization view modes, we can have a better look at how our scene is actually being rendered and what's causing, potentially causing some issues. I'll turn on the shader complexity. It's going to be pretty red, which means that we are using some, you know, a lot of heavy shaders. Now for this scene, this is a visually heavy scene, but that's also what our goal with this scene was, try to push our limits of what we can create in Pixotope and still be running at a steady frame rate. But using this, you can clearly see, you know, what kind of shaders are pulling a lot of performance and what's more lights. Everything red here is obviously, you know, danger areas. Doesn't necessarily need to be the main issue if you're having performance problems, but it's good to check because it could be causing some problems. You see the flag here hanging down, that's, you know, causing no trouble. Same with the bikes here. But the buildings, they have a lot of, these are pretty complex because they have inputs for rain, for snow, that kind of stuff. So it all depends what you're doing in your shaders. But it's a good way to be able to look at your scene. And you should play around with these. Once you have a scene set up, you can get a lot of input into how your scene is working, what's going on. So it's always good to check these things while you're working to make sure that nothing is sort of overtaking most of your performance.